On the CEO's Chair today, we're really excited to have a third generation entrepreneur, Mr. Prasanna Patwardhan. Mr. Patwardhan is the managing director of Prasanna Purple Mobility Solutions. He's also a national level basketball player as well as a coach. And he joined his father's business accidentally over 3 decades ago, taking it from a turnover of about 3.5 lakhs to over 300 crores today. Mr. Patwardhan, welcome to the CEO's Chair.
Thank you.
Mr. Patwardhan, you spent so many of your early years being involved with sports across all levels. What are some of the learnings that you've taken from sports into the world of business?
I have learned more from sports than anything else.
Okay.
Lesser in education and more in sports. So, sports teaches you a lot of things.
True.
The most important thing is there is nothing like win and you lose.
Okay.
So, you win some, you lose some.
Absolutely.
So, there is always a win after a lose and lose after a win.
Very true.
So, that is the biggest thing which you learn first. Second, there is nothing called as your enemy or friend.
Okay.
It is just opponent, and he could be on your side or he could be on other side. So when you play for a club, you are opponent to other club members.
Okay.
But when you play for district,
correct,
then you play together.
The same,
same is the case for state championship. And when you play national, all Indians are your friends. So that is the most important learning one learns.
Okay.
And which becomes very useful when you enter business. Third thing I would say, one must play a competitive event, competitive
okay.
sports, because that also gives you opportunity to play on different positions. Because fortunately for me, I played for 3 different teams in a single year.
That's amazing.
And in a single day also, I played 3 different games. So when it was under 17.5, I was the boss because I was the captain.
Absolutely.
When under 21 game, I was one of the equal, I would say.
Correct.
And when it came to seniors, I used to carry people's clothes and give them water.
And that's fine.
So, in business, particularly when you start your business, it is very important to keep on changing your roles. In business, when actually you are working in your own company, you are the boss. When you are working in associations, organizations, trade associations, then you are equal with everybody. And when you are working with government, of course, they are the boss and you are the subordinate. So you need to carry those clothes.
And it's, I think it also teaches you a lot of humility, like you were rightly saying.
Correct, correct. What is important is when you win, you don't only earn money.
Correct.
Along with money, you also earn goodwill of the people.
And respect.
You get respect from people. You build that trust among the people, among the society.
Correct.
And when you have people around you, those who are willing to support you, you don't feel that bad time is really a bad time. So I always believe that bankruptcy in terms of money is okay to have.
Okay.
But bankruptcy in terms of trust of people is very dangerous to have.
Absolutely.
So bankruptcy in goodwill, never have that bankruptcy. So one of the thing I would like to share one story.
Yes, please.
I saw TV serial.
Okay.
You also must have seen it. Chanakya.
Correct.
So there is a scene where Chanakya is sitting in front of God outside his town or outside the capital.
Okay.
And he looks depressed, but he's talking to God. And he says, "Hey God, a king whom I made, he threw me out of his darbar."
Correct.
"And the janta for whom I did all this, that also disowned me today. But still I have no regrets, no complaints about it. Because till the time you keep my brain intact, which is behind all this, I can build all of this again."
Wow.
So this is the story which keeps inspiring me all the time.
So basically, according to you, attitude is the most important.
Of course,
your
positive
mindset is
most important. You should always remain positive.
And hardships are a true test of your relationships with people as well.
Yes.
Because there are times when you think that somebody will be there for you.
Yes.
And unfortunately that they are not.
Yes.
So if anything, people should be facing hardships in their life.
Yes. See, we had difficulty in dealing with only date related projects.
Okay.
So that time I decided that it is very important for me to start approaching equity.
Okay. And this we're talking about 2007, 2008.
Yeah. Between 2005 to 2008.
Okay.
I started searching for equity. When you search for equity, it is very important that you search for the right partner.
Absolutely.
So there are different kind of partners. When you are in startup, you look at, say, angel capital.
Correct.
Or venture capital.
True.
But we required growth capital.
Okay.
Because we were not a startup. We were an established company. I pitched to different forums. I made a presentation to different people. And fortunately, I got one gentleman.
Okay.
And he believed in me. And Ambit Pragma is the company, and Rajiv Agarwal is the person
okay.
who believed in me,
okay.
and they invested in our company.
Amazing.
And that is how we got that equity.
Okay.
But I would say for startup, it is very important that they should choose the right partner.
Correct.
They should study well, and there has to be a right partner at the right time.
Okay.
Similarly, right kind of money at the right time.
Can you elaborate a little bit more on that?
So, I have seen many people, they, in fact, I have done that.
Okay.
So, they raise large capital.
Correct.
When it is not required at that point of time.
Okay.
So, you lose a lot of equity.
True.
And going forward, that capital gets employed. But when you take it upfront.
Correct.
There is a tendency that you don't use it the way it has to be used. So it has to be used in right fashion, in right manner,
correct.
For right purpose.
True.
So when you have large amount of money coming up front, that does not happen. So you should raise a capital according to your plan, which will suffice your initial purpose.
Okay.
So dilute your equity only to that extent.
As much as is required.
Yeah. Then go to second round of funding because okay. your valuation is going to go up.
Very true.
And keep on going series 1, series 2, series 3. But I would say for startup, they should remain lean
okay.
and agile, which is most important.
And you had a very nice saying when we were talking offline about treating the investor money like it's your own money. If you were to take investment today in your company, what would you do differently that you didn't do maybe in 2008?
See, another point which you raised correctly
correct.
Is when that money comes, we believe that this is not our money. So you have ability to spend that money,
true.
But at the same time, you don't believe that it is your money.
Correct.
And which is a very dangerous situation to have. What your money comes in, it is the money which you have raised against your equity.
Absolutely.
So that is your money. So you should spend it wisely.
True.
So spending wisely. So I would say I should have spent that money more wisely on technology.
Okay.
Building systems and processes and building a great team rather than keep on buying vehicles, which I used to do when I used to take debt. Still, we take debt for our vehicle
true.
Loans, but equity should be used for different purpose.
Okay.
And that I would do certainly differently if I buy equity now. I will use it more wisely today and for the right purpose. Honestly speaking, I don't understand this Robin Hood model, so-called Robin Hood model, where you collect money from high net worth individuals.
Correct.
And you lose money and give services to general public. 99% of the people, they fail.
Correct.
They lose money. And that is because they don't have that passion for that trade or for the idea which they want to promote. So it is very important to have that fire in your belly.
Okay.
So you should be passionate and you yourself should be confident about the model which you are selling.
It should be sustainable.
Yeah, it should be sustainable. It should be expandable. It should
true.
Be expandable fast. That is first thing which is very important.
Okay.
Second is when you are entering into any new field,
correct.
You must study that field.
Okay.
Without studying, just for the sake of collecting money, if you make some Excel projects or some projects to impress people, you may be able to impress people. But you will not be able to succeed.
Very true.
So you need to study well, plan well,
okay.
and execute it well. Execution is the key. Okay. I have seen many people, their only aim in life is to raise funds, sell that idea to somebody else,
and then do it all over again.
So if you are serial entrepreneur and okay. if you have ability to build organization, then you can do that. Organization is all about people, train people, systems and processes, and the way you execute the things. So if you have that ability, then you can become serial entrepreneur. But otherwise, you should follow your passion. That is what I think is more important. And that is what I have been doing it all along.
and we talk about a lot of people that are enamored by the idea of entrepreneurship, but not everybody is cut out for entrepreneurship as well. And that's okay, right? I'm sure you have a lot of people.
I don't think so. So if you are not ready to forgo your monthly salary, if you are not willing to work after 9 to 5, you are not ready to be an entrepreneur.
Absolutely.
In entrepreneurship, there is no time limit. You are 24/7 on the job. There is no guarantee that you will earn money every month.
Absolutely.
You might lose money, you will have to borrow money. And third very important thing is, you need to be ready to do any kind of job. Jhadu marna hai, to jhadu bhi marna hai.
Whatever is required.
So whatever is required, you need to do that.
Correct.
And if you are not ready to do that, please don't become entrepreneur. Entrepreneur is a dream of many people.
Right, true.
But they are not willing to compromise. Entrepreneurship is all about compromises.
Completely agree.
And if you are willing to do that, then you are ready. See, in our business, there are many companies.
Correct.
They work in different models.
Mm-hmm.
So there are, most of them are European companies.
Okay.
So, like, I have visited quite a few of them,
I'm sure.
Or many of them, I would say. So nowadays, things are changing from isolated transportation to integrated transportation.
Correct.
So they are mostly into integrated transportation. I just visited one company, Keolis, in Lyon.
Okay.
So they starting from bicycle to train, they run all the systems.
That's amazing.
So single ticket and you are able to get everywhere. So there are companies in England,
mm-hmm.
like First Group is one, Arriva is second. So there are many companies in our field.
Okay.
But I admire companies, those who change people's life.
True.
Like Apple, Microsoft. So providing general transportation is okay.
Correct.
But unless you add value to people's life, you are doing nothing.
No, but I'm confident that you are, because Prasanna Purple Mobility is a name that is synonymous with travel, especially in this part of the country as well. You have a very interesting concept of hop on, hop off bus that you've been running in Delhi for a couple
yes.
of years.
Goa also.
In Goa as well. So you are definitely making an impact, and I'm sure people can feel it. The feedback that you get from your customers and your clients is testimony to that fact. You travel still to this day, still after 30 years of joining your business, about what, 2 weeks in a month? 15
yeah.
days of the month,
yes.
you're still traveling.
Yes.
There's a lot of stress that comes with traveling as well. How do you manage that stress?
It all depends on your priorities.
Okay.
Your stress has direct relation to your priorities. So I have defined my priorities like, my first priority is my health.
Okay.
Second priority is my relationships. And third priority is wealth. If
in
you
that
reverse
all-
that, you'll be stressful. Second is, when it comes to relationship,
mm-hmm.
you need to build three different kind of relationships.
Okay.
One is, of course, family.
Of course.
So I was very fortunate to have a wife which took care of my entire family, though I was staying in joint family. She took care of everything. So I never bothered even 1% about my family.
That's amazing. Thank you.
You. See,
thank you, Mrs. Patwardhan.
but that is the kind of care she took. So she took my family's care entirely. And thanks to her, because of her, I could never get that stress from family side.
True. And she's still actively involved in running the
now
business.
She is actively involved in our holiday business. So
okay.
she takes care of our holiday business.
Okay.
My son takes care of our logistics business.
Of course.
My other son takes care of our footwear manufacturing or leather manufacturing business.
Correct.
So that also helps you quite a lot.
I'm sure.
Secondly, when you have relationship with your friends,
mm-hmm.
You cherish that relationship. That is the biggest de-stressor, I would say.
Absolutely.
The time you spent with them, you don't feel stressed.
Especially the old friends that you've
yeah,
known.
Yeah, old friends, your college friends or real friends, I would say.
Correct.
So I do it quite often.
Okay.
So that is also one of the way to de-stress yourself. And that also gives you confidence that during bad time, these people are around you.
Very true.
So which helped me during, I would like to share one story.
Please.
Here. During my Smilestone times, which was a bad period, I would say, our motel business became NPA, and because of which our main business was hampered.
Okay.
And I was after bank to give me one time settlement. So bank gave me one time settlement and said that you need to deposit 7 crores before 31st of March. And this happened on 12th of March.
Oh my God.
So on 12th of March, they told me that you need to deposit money, which is 7 crore, before 31st of March, then only we'll give you OTS. So it was a big challenge.
I'm sure.
I accepted it.
Okay.
And I had only 2 crores in my bank, which was in no-lien account with them only. So I approached all my friends and family.
Okay.
And I told them this is what is required. So how can you help me? And on 28th of March, I could gather 7 crore 15 lakh rupees.
Wow.
So this is the kind of support when you have, you don't need to take that stress.
True.
And I could deposit that money on 28th, not 31st of March, and get rid of that loan.
I'm sure even the bank manager must have been amazed. Yeah. He never expected
yeah,
that.
Yeah, they never
life.
Expected that I could do that. Because they had said, if you don't deposit before 31st of March,
correct.
You will need to pay 11 crores, which is a normal
absolutely.
Loan amount. But I could do that. So this is the kind of strength what you have. Third, when you have good relationship with your employees.
Correct.
I could not pay them salaries for months during that period. Still, they stayed with me. And that is because they had trust in me that this person will certainly pay us. And that is the kind of trust one needs to build.
Absolutely. And that is not something that is built overnight.
Yeah. So we have delegation.
Okay.
And that delegation, I would say, is very, very important. Because with delegation, then you are relaxed. But I have seen many owners.
Cannot delegate.
They cannot delegate.
Correct.
And they employ people, but they still work by themselves.
And micromanage.
Micromanage. So it is important to give relationship. It is built relationship. It is important to delegate.
Correct.
At the same time, it is important to empower them.
Mr. Patwardhan, thank you so much for being on the CEO's chair. It's great to see that even after so many years, the humility and the passion that you display for your business is very, very evident.
Thank you.
The customer focus is very evident. And in my opinion, you're definitely a success because not only have you managed to raise a successful family, keep a wife happy, but you've also been able to surround yourself with people and friends that obviously you cherish a lot. So for everyone out there who's watching, please keep in mind that passion for whatever you do is very important. Research for whatever you do is very important. And please strive to be the best version of yourself, like Mr. Patwardhan here, who's a great role model and an example for all of us. Please continue watching The CEO's Chair and see you soon next time.